Okay. Hi. Hello. I don't even know how to start this.
I know. I mean, jumping to the chase here. Yeah, we're having another baby.
I'm pregnant! I don't know. It feels weird to be, like, talking about this and vlogging about this because unlike with my pregnancy with Grace, where I feel like we had filmed so much leading up to the announcement, that whole announcement vlog was like, okay, the first ultrasound and this and that. And, like, other than one random clip I filmed after we found out the gender, we haven't said this to a camera.
Yeah. Yep. Exactly. It's so weird even, like, talking about this. It's, like, it's just so weird. It's finally, it's coming! I think it's like, an epitome of the whole experience so far. Like, we found out, so exciting, and that whole, you know, world of emotions. And now we're just going, and it feels like it's going by so quick. And that's like, oh, we gotta, like, we should post a video.
Yeah, like, we've told all our family and friends. We're past, like, the beginning, you know, really scary time, especially with, you know, what we've dealt with in the past. Mm-hmm. Like, there's a lot of anxiety in the first trimester, and I'm now 14 weeks.
Yeah.
Which, I don't know, I feel like this pregnancy has flown by.
It has. And Sierra and I were just talking about this, and, like, I feel like it's for a bunch of reasons. Like, one, like, this pregnancy is not during a pandemic.
Right. Last time it was, we were just at home. There was nothing else really filling our time.
Right. And so work was really slow. Like, we were both working from home. I don't know. So it's like, we were able to, like really just sit in everything for so long, and it felt so slow and special. And, like,
I remember feeling like every day was, like, crawling by, and I just wanted to, like, fast forward to Grace being here. And I think that's the other part. Now having a toddler, mm-hmm. I don't feel that at all. Of like, oh, I wish I was already 9 months pregnant and giving birth. I'm like, oh, I don't want to miss this time with Grace, this last bit of her being an only child, and I don't want to miss Christmas this year and Halloween and all the special moments we're going to have with her leading up to having our second kid.
Yeah, like, in every sense of the word, life is just so busy right now, and it's like,
Yeah.
So, like, without a doubt, April's going to come so quick.
Yeah.
Speaking of which.
April.
Speaking of things keeping us busy, Grace. So Grace is so cute. She's so excited. So she clearly understands everything that's going to happen.
More than I thought she would.
Yeah.
And I think it helps that a lot of our friends who have kids have multiple kids. And so she understands the idea of, like, a sibling. She's been asking us when we're going to have a baby for, like, longer than just about anyone.
Yeah, exactly.
So she couldn't be more excited. She talks about
She's
baby
so
all the time.
And, like, when we didn't know the gender yet, we had, you know, hey, Grace, who do you think? Do you think it's going to be a boy or a girl? And then she was like, boy. And then she just, for whatever reason, locked on to Prince Eric. She'd be like, good night, Mama. Good night, Prince Eric. Like,
she would always touch my belly, and she'd be like, and Prince Eric's in there. You know what? I have a couple clips of that. So let's Prince Eric clips here.
My baby's tummy.
There is a baby in Mommy's tummy. That's right.
Miss Eric.
You want to name him Prince Eric?
Silly.
That is so silly.
Which I guess brings us to another part. We found out what we're having.
Yes, we're having a girl.
We are having another girl.
So.
And I'm so excited.
I know. It is such an exciting little journey. And it's such an exciting little family we're going to find ourselves in, so.
Yeah, we're going to have two girls. Yeah. Grace is going to have a sister.
Steve is officially a girl dad.
You are such a girl dad. And, you know, it's funny, I remember saying that to you, like, when we first started talking about having kids.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, I don't know, I just feel like, you're kind of a girl dad. Like, you're so, like, loving and gentle and compassionate. And obviously those are, I think, characteristics that, like, all men should have and all children should have in a parent.
Mm-hmm.
But there was just something about it that I was like, I just feel like you would be such an amazing dad to girls. And here we are.
I've had a wonderful little journey with Grace so far, so
yeah,
I am super on board for being a girl dad.
I think also, for whatever reason, like, finding out it was a girl really is what made it, like, sink into me. I think also having a lot of, like, anxiety about past pregnancy loss.
Mm-hmm.
Once I didn't know the sex for either of those pregnancies that we lost, and so finding out that it was a girl made me feel like, this is gonna happen for me. Like, this is gonna happen for us. This is real, and, like, I think I need to start letting myself accept that it's real, and I think I was trying to protect myself by not accepting it so much, and that day that we found out, I felt like I was like, okay, this is, like, meant to be.
I'm working at my desk, and I just started crying. I just started crying, like, the happiest tears, because yesterday, we found out the sex. We found out that we are having a girl. I didn't like really have a preference before. And when I went in and did the blood test, I remember like kind of thinking both ways. And it was just like, I wonder what it'll be. But still like so fearful of loss and getting too attached and finding out that it's a girl. I just had this like feeling of peace of like, this pregnancy is gonna work out and this is the way our family is meant to be, and we're gonna have two little girls. Grace is gonna have a sister, and I feel like learning that has just allowed me to feel like this is real, and I'm just so happy.
I'd say for me, that kind of moment happened, it was just in one of the last ultrasounds we just did. And it's been cool because now we're not in a pandemic. I can go to every appointment.
Yeah, and last time you only got to go to the anatomy scan at 20 weeks.
Yeah. Seeing, like, her move and everything, I was like, oh my gosh, like, this is a full-blown human. Like, this is coming. Like,
yeah. And we got to see, like, her spine and her brain and her legs. Yep, and
so excited.
So excited.
So excited, and just cannot believe that this is all going to be happening again, so.
Yeah. I'm so excited to be going through this with you again, and, like, it is so special going through this with you and with Grace.
Yeah.
And we also have, like, just such an amazing village around us who is, like, sharing in this excitement with us. Not to mention, like, so many people in our lives are pregnant right now.
Yes. So we have Sierra's older brother.
Yes. And his wife, Megan, is pregnant. And the telling them was, like, the best for me.
That was the most exciting part. It was like, hey, we're only, like, what is it, like, 2 months?
Yeah, we're, like, two months behind them.
We have Rachel on the team is pregnant.
Yes.
That's exciting.
So exciting. It's been fun, like, having friends pregnant at the same time. Like, when I was pregnant with Grace, Kenzie was at the same time as me. And it was just so, it made me feel so much less isolated.
Yeah.
And so much more seen. And I've really had that this time, you know, like, I was texting Rachel about, like, I was like, I'm so embarrassing. I just Postmated a single baked potato from Wendy's because that's the only thing I could eat. And she, like, sent me her Postmates order from, like, 2 weeks earlier, and she had done the same thing. And, like, just stupid little things like that. And then, like, with Megan, it's like, oh, not just being pregnant at the same time, but, like, when we told them that we were pregnant, it's like, we're gonna have cousins together.
Right.
Like,
right. And it's their first kids. Like, that excitement of, like, the first kid. And then we just found out one of my good friends is pregnant.
Yeah, that was actually crazy. We texted them in Steven's, like, group chat of his friends, and we were like, surprise! Like,
we're having a baby.
And everyone was like, oh my gosh, da-da-da-da. And then Steven's friend Christina goes, ... plot twist, and sends a picture of an ultrasound. They are also pregnant, her and her husband, 2 days behind us.
Yeah, that's bananas.
It's so wild. And then the whole group chat, we were like, what? So, and that we just found out about like a couple weeks ago. So that's been super exciting. And
yeah, so
just so much excitement, so much love. And especially now that I'm out of the time of feeling so sick, mostly.
Yep. And then, yeah, so looking backwards a little bit, like, even, like, the whole first trimester thing with, you know, morning sickness. Yeah. I was surprised. So, obviously, you did get sick again.
But way less than with Grace. Yes. With Grace, I felt like I would throw up in the morning, and then, it wasn't just morning sickness. I was, like, nauseous and sick and shaky all day.
Yeah. When it's, like, it's also second kid-isms category, but, like, you also, like, there were days where you had no choice but to do that. So, like, I think by not having a choice, like, you got constantly were having to do stuff. And
yeah.
I don't know. So, I think those, like, second kid-isms, like, you know, like, just the experience would be totally different because at the end of the day, there is a 2-year-old who demands our full attention.
Right.
8 a.m. to 8 p.m. every single day. Can't be like, oh, mommy, you have morning sickness? Okay, I'll go play with my toys for a little bit while you deal with that. It's like, nope. Mommy, you done yet? Like,
yeah, navigating nausea and caring for a toddler has been interesting. And we've really been trying to, like, keep a normal routine with her through everything, too. But there were a couple times when I was at her classes with her and I was like, I am going to go throw up in a bush and then we will come back in and continue. But yeah, nausea was mainly for me at this time, like, 6 to 10 weeks, but really, like, true morning sickness. And then now it's just been, like, random occasional times, but mostly feeling pretty good. And the main thing has just been exhaustion. I feel like this pregnancy versus with Grace, which probably also now having a toddler, like we said, yeah. I'm so tired all the time. Like, yeah. So tired.
Yeah, and I think that's the second kidisms. Like, you're having to push through a lot more. And you're having to have longer days. And, like, you know, I help out as much as I can, but still, yeah. Like, you just need to push a lot more than you had to first time around with Grace.
Totally.
Right? So now you're way more tired this time around.
That's also why I feel like in a lot of vlogs lately, I've always been like, I'm so tired. Like, I'm going to go lay on the couch. I'm going to bed. It's 8 o'clock. And there's actually been a lot of stuff like that that I've cut out of the vlogs or that I've been like, I shouldn't film this because this is giving first trimester.
Right.
Because I wanted to keep it private at the beginning, but I also didn't want to take a break from vlogging. And when I was pregnant with Grace, I didn't vlog at all during the first trimester. The only filming that I did during the first trimester with Grace, we shared after the fact. I wasn't posting then.
And then we kept pretty good check-ins, yes. right?
Whereas now I've been still filming throughout, but just like, you know, I do a happy little morning montage and the part you didn't see was me throwing up as soon as I woke up or me trying to down my prenatals and not gag and all that kind of stuff. It's been interesting. And even I feel like I was talking to you about this earlier. I kind of started to get in my head about like I was like, oh, I can't share this because someone might see it as a pregnancy thing, or like, oh, I shouldn't show during my skincare routine because I stopped using my retinol cream, and you can't use retinol when you're pregnant, so someone's gonna figure it out. And I think I got a little overly obsessive with it, which then just in general made me kind of like pull back from sharing.
Right.
Like, I filmed a whole clip where I was like holding a lollipop because lollipops have helped a lot with my nausea, and then I was like, Steven, I think I need to cut this. Like,
I can't be eating a lollipop.
When have I ever eaten a lollipop, like, other than when I was pregnant? I don't know. So it's nice. It was really nice, I think, to keep it private for us when we did, especially when, you know, anxiety was really at a peak and everything, and it was still so early. But I am really excited and feeling good about telling you guys about this now and being able to vlog a little bit more candidly.
Yeah.
And not be so in my head about trying to keep this a secret.
Gosh. Yeah, so Sierra's pregnant.
I'm pregnant.
Gonna have a little baby girl in April.
So excited.
And we're very excited.
Yes.
Yeah, so I think that's pretty much our little spiel that we wanted to cover real quick.
Yeah.
Today's actually pretty exciting. We're actually gonna go take the pregnancy photos. But yeah, so Tony's coming down. We're going to take some photos at the pumpkin patch. So that will be fun.
Grace is napping right now. So we're like, okay, let's film this now. And then when she wakes up, go into the pumpkin patch, going to take some pictures.
Yeah, and it's cute. I think some of my favorite photos of Grace have, for whatever reason, been at our annual pumpkin patch visit. I don't know why. It's just, they're always really cute. And I don't know. It's some of my favorite pictures. So I have expectations that will again happen this year, but we'll see.
I'm excited. I think it'll be fun. I mean, fun just to take family pictures in general, because we haven't done that in a while. Yeah. And fun to kind of be taking a step into announcing this. And
yeah.
We have our ultrasound photos from our 13-week scan we're going to bring with us, which also, I think, before we go, I'll show you guys the ultrasound photos that we have so far and kind of walk you through, because also we've had 4 ultrasounds so far, which is more than 4? Usual. Yeah, because we have 5-week, 8-week, 10-week, and 13-week.
5-week one is early.
Mm-hmm. And because of my past miscarriages, they do more ultrasounds with my pregnancies, so that has been good, at least for like peace of mind of having those extra check-ins. And
yeah, all right, let's go to the pumpkin patch.
Yeah, or well, go see the ultrasound photos and then pumpkin patch.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so here are the ultrasounds we've had so far. We got our first one at, I think this was 5 weeks. And you can see, well, the thing is you can't really see. There's just a little teeny speck that they're measuring there in my uterus. But as much as it may not look like much, this was super validating to me to see what you don't get to see with a pregnancy test and see that those two lines were really something. And we got to hear the heartbeat at this appointment too, which was really special. This was back in August, and then the next ultrasound, you can see little baby right there. This was 8 weeks. And between these two appointments, I think my fear definitely like started to get the better of me a little bit. And I remember going to this appointment like almost sure that there wouldn't be growth and that something would have gone wrong. But baby was there and measuring where she was supposed to be. We did have one little hiccup at this appointment, though. I had a subchorionic hematoma, which is this little kind of black line that you see right here. That's actually a little pocket of blood. And subchorionic hematomas are really common. I actually had one when I was pregnant with Grace pretty early on that caused me to have some bleeding that I, you know, went to the hospital for, and they were like, no, baby's okay. It's a subchorionic hematoma. I didn't know what it was then, but obviously that was like a huge relief. And I had to go on like a modified bed rest for a little bit with that one, but it ended up, you know, being fine. And I think having that experience made this less scary to me. I also didn't have any spotting this time with the subchorionic hematoma, and at the next appointment it had healed up. So very, very grateful for that. Which is here at 11 weeks, we got to see our little baby growing and that the subchorionic hematoma had healed. So that was very good news. And then it was shortly after this appointment that I did the NIPT blood test, the non-invasive prenatal testing. It's like a genetic test. Or I think actually that was a little bit before this ultrasound, because it was just a couple days after this appointment that I got the results back, and everything came back good on the genetic test. And that's also when we found out that we were having a girl. So I feel like it was around this appointment that it really started setting in, and that I really started to allow myself to get really excited. And we had already told some of our like close circle at this point, but it was after that that we're like, okay, I feel good. I feel ready to like tell all the people in our lives. And so that's been kind of the past couple weeks, is sharing the exciting news with everyone and now getting to share it with you guys. And then this ultrasound, this is from last week. This was our most recent scan. And this is like, this is the point when Steven said like, oh my gosh, this is getting so real. It's really sinking in. At the appointment, we got to see like so much detail and see baby moving, and everything looked great here too. And it was just so exciting. So this little print of ultrasound photos we are bringing with us to the pumpkin patch. I've been trying to keep these really nice so that they don't look all crumpled in the photo. Some of these have been not kept quite as nice, and you know, Grace has really enjoyed looking at them. They've been a little manhandled, but that's okay. These ones though, I've been keeping in an envelope, in a folder. So yeah, bringing these with us. We're gonna go get dressed, get ready for the pumpkin patch, get everything set for the photo shoot, and take these announcement photos. I can't believe we're doing this today. It's in my brain, I'm still like so early in the pregnancy. I'm like, what am I? Eight weeks, six weeks? No, I'm 14 weeks. And we're gonna post this announcement like soon. It's wild. It's, oh my gosh. That is our news. That is our pregnancy announcement for our next sweet little baby coming into the family, baby girl.
Our newest pumpkin in the pumpkin patch.
Steven was like, that's how we should caption the photo. I was like, that's like a meme.
I tried lobbying for a pumpkin patch pun announcement.
I mean, we haven't posted it yet, so you still have time to persuade me.
I am losing the battle. So if you see this and you see a pumpkin patch pun, just know that Steven, I'm victorious.
I'm like, we can do separate posts. You can make yours. Oh, we got it, picked up a new pumpkin at the patch. Whatever you want.
Oh, gosh. Anyways, thanks for watching.
Bye.
Bye.